Yeah, Jana, when talking about planning, that is certainly fair. And it's been true since the beginning of the pandemic. If you just look at September, airline tickets actually bucked the inflation trend, falling in price due, of course, to the spread of the Delta variant. But even the airlines themselves are expecting a departure from that in the weeks to come.
There are a lot of reasons why you might be hesitant to buy plane tickets right now. But if you're simply waiting to see if you can snag a deal on a holiday season flight, it might be a good time to just get on board.
It's a good time to get a deal. These big economic factors could ultimately influence the price of a plane ticket. And so it wouldn't hurt to lock in something now, especially if you're talking about traveling for Thanksgiving or Christmas or New Year's.
Kyle Potter, executive editor of thriftytraveler.com, says right now all airlines are facing increasing costs on two major fronts. Not only are they raising wages to deal with a worker shortage, but at the end of September, federal subsidies to offset those employee costs went away.
That gave airlines a lot of runway to keep plane ticket costs low. I don't know quite yet how that's going to shake out.
And if you pair that concern with fuel costs, which have also taken off and taken a toll on Delta Airlines stock today, he says that's why ticket prices could be in for some turbulence.
If someone's looking at buying their first plane ticket for a holiday travel season in a while or something like that, what would you tell people to be prepared for?
There are less options out there, and you might need to be a little bit more flexible than you needed to be just a few years ago.
And you might need to remain flexible even after you've booked. Look no further than last week's meltdown at Southwest Airlines, in which roughly 2,500 flights were canceled in 5 days.
Is that a concern, that travel's maybe gonna become more unreliable in the months to come?
Yeah, it's a huge concern. I've been thinking a lot that it's high time for the United States government to do something that gives passengers some rights, some guaranteed rights when they buy a plane ticket. Because today, the only right that you and I have is if our airline cancels our flight, we're entitled to get a refund, and airlines don't even do a good job with that. These airlines are so eager to carry as many passengers as they can that they are stretched so incredibly thin that if you introduce one problem into the equation, the entire operation can fall apart really, really fast. I do fear it's only a matter of time before the next airline melts down.
But if you're not as worried about your itinerary changing or flying on the busiest days, Kyle says there are and will continue to be great deals in the air.
Probably more so than ever, airlines are going to be at each other's throats trying to win back some of the business that they've lost over the past 18 months. And that dynamic is not going anywhere anytime soon. And that is a huge win for people who like a cheap plane ticket.
Now, to give you one idea of how much these cost concerns could impact air travel, the Delta CEO said today that for every 5 cents per gallon that fuel goes up, it results in $40 million in additional operating costs. And that really adds up when you consider that today fuel prices are up 40% over a year ago. Jana.
Ooh, this is a tough economic forecast so far. Thanks, Ken.